you're out there playing gigs, playing professionally, trying to make it in the music business, and somehow, you talked about baseball a minute ago, a sort of left curve or curveball came your way. MOTR Drummer shows up, which I imagine you were familiar with before. How did that gig come about that you got to be managing editor?
Yeah, well, the short story is, in graduate school, I took a class called music journalism, and it was taught by my predecessor at MOTR Drummer. So he would come down once a week, maybe 2 days a week, and I was actually assigned to be his assistant as well. So if he came down to teach, you know, a freshman drum set class or whatever, I had to be there to, you know, make copies of his handouts and just kind of assist. So every time he came down, I was in his face, so basically. And he taught that music journalism class that I was in. So I just took to the subject matter. I'd never written really anything before. I'd never done any kind of journalism before, creative writing. But I'd been reading MOTR Drummer since 1991 or something. So I just, the content of MOTR Drummer I was very familiar with. And I was and still am a huge drum nerd. So everything drums and drumming, I'm completely obsessed with. So I just took to the concept of editing and writing very quickly. And he saw something at the end of the year. He said, hey, we actually need to bring another editor on board. I'm going to put your name in the list for recommendations. And that's literally how it happened.
Amazing.
I mean, I had an article published when I was still in grad school. And then the end of the year, I was offered the job. So I had maybe 90 days between graduating and having a job, which was kind of, I mean, I couldn't have asked for a better blessing.
Right. That's amazing. It's amazing. Can you give us a typical day in the life of the managing editor at MOTR Drummer?
Typical day. Up early. I'm usually testing products in the morning before I come to the office. So there's a drum set, cymbals, whatever. I'm usually making some kind of a demo video or something. If not every day, it's most days I'm doing that. I have to come in at 9 o'clock. So I'm here. And then I just usually, most days, it's usually a mix of trafficking articles from freelance writers, whether it's product reviews or educational things or whatever, making sure the photos and everything is going in and out the way it needs to, proofreading articles that are ready, you know, about to be published, sitting down with the rest of the editorial staff to discuss new ideas and what we want to do in the future. What else? Always researching, checking out new bands, checking out new drummers. I mean, I'm probably on YouTube. YouTube is always open. So at any time I see a drummer's name, I'm just looking for them. What are they up to? What do they got going on? And that's pretty much between that. I mean, that takes up a whole day. And then we just do it again.
Right. That's busy. You certainly, I'm sure, have evolved in your writing. When you're getting article submissions from freelance writers, what are you looking for? What makes a good article in MOTR Drummer or any other kind of publication?
That's a really good question. I would say having a unique angle on the subject matter is usually the best thing. Something that's not, you know, beautifully written can be reworked. I can make something flow. I can improve someone's flow. I can't improve the way they think and compose their ideas. So with a clear, concise, compelling idea, I almost always accept that over something that's really flowery and beautifully written, but has, when you start whittling away the words, you're like, there's nothing there. There's actually nothing there. It's just a bunch of words. So that's always what I'm looking for. Just give me something to chew on, concept-wise.